And you were a menace to society. How cool was that?
It was the best, man. I played Jada Pinkett's son as a young child. It was great. I did a couple TV shows before, so really, you know, really was nothing. But
and you've been Jordan Farmar's friend from what, first grade, huh?
Since first grade, man. We met on the basketball. Matter of fact, no, we met at the YMCA. We ended up on the same team, and then first day of school, I looked up and we're like, hey, we're on the same team. So best friends ever since, man.
That watch was telling me you're like the 1-2 combo.
Oh, what?
For life.
Jordan and Pippen, right?
For life.
We were really phenomenal, man, at such a young age. We really understood the game, really had a passion for it.
So how amazing is it to see what's going on here with them today?
Oh, really? We've been talking about it all week. It's so stoked because I've been a camper. You know, I was at the Eddie Jones camp. I went to a couple camps before. To really have his own camp, more than anything, is the best. You know, and to see the love and the morale here. And then as far as everybody in the coaching staff is, you know, coaches that he's had, coaches that I've had, friends and family. It's really a great experience.
What can you tell about Jordan that nobody knows?
One thing about Jordan, Jordan's probably one of the kindest people I've ever met in my life. I know a lot of people see him and they see him in the court and he is one of the kindest people I've ever met. If he had $5 and you needed a dollar, he'd be the person to give it.
Favorite moment growing up with him? You guys have been through some
favorite
stuff.
Favorite moment. Matter of fact, in this gym, Poly Pavilion, it was before we were with Coach Watts. That was one of my favorite moments. We were in the championship finals for NBA for the Junior Lakers program. And we're up 20, or 15 rather, and going into the third quarter. We're up there taunting the crowd, you know, hey.
How old were you?
We were at 10 years old.
And you ended up losing?
Ended up losing.
That's
and we're sitting
happened.
There crying. At the end of the court, that's my favorite moment.
It just takes me back to when Julian and Jordan were kids, and you know, we're all happy for Jordan, but I'm happy for all of the kids because, you know, as kids don't realize it, but basketball will always keep your friendships together.
It will. Everybody we know here is through basketball. Right?
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing you and Watts coached him and now you guys just hung out with him?
Hey, it's a blessing. I'm so happy for Watts, myself, Jordan, all the kids, all the campers. Okay, it's a great day.
It's like a festival.
I didn't have anything like this when I was a kid. And these kids are really blessed. And you can tell they really appreciate it. You know, taking well to all the talk, you know, all the counselors. So this is great. It's wonderful.
Jordan was outgoing, but Jordan was a hard worker. You know, he did things that most kids didn't do. He asked to stay after practice, he asked for help, and it was some nights we'd be at the gym at 9, 10 o'clock, you know, just working on different things, different aspects of the game. But, I mean, Jordan was outgoing, he was funny, and a pleasure to have.
You know? Favorite moment with him that you can remember?
Yeah, I can. Favorite moment with Jordan, we had a scrimmage game against Hoop Masters. They were just, particular team with Hoop Masters were defending national champs, and we had set up a scrimmage with our wide. And Jordan had like 24 points against Gabe Poort, who was just recently with the Celtics. Gabe was a youth. And I remember at the end of the game, the coach came up. He said, you know what? He said, this kid is special. He's going somewhere.